That actually works. On behalf of the Church Music Publishers Association and the National Music Publishers Association, I want to welcome you tonight. Thank you so much for joining us in a celebration of the American songwriter. We've got a very exciting program, and so we're going to jump right into it. It is an absolute thrill for me to introduce the woman who's going to open for Steven Tyler. Mindy Brash started taking music lessons when she was about 5 years old. At 12, she wrote her first song. And at about 16, as her parents were driving her on a 16-hour round trip to Nashville so that she could further her craft, she decided that she wanted to make music her life. And she's been living in Nashville ever since, now at the old age of 18. You're gonna hear tonight two original songs that Mindy wrote. And what I want you to understand is that someday, when she becomes an overnight success, it's because of the years of hard work that she put into her craft, and she deserves to be fairly compensated for her work. She is very lucky that she found a man named Bart Herbison who runs the Nashville Songwriters Association, who's been mentoring her and introduced her to me. And when I heard her play, I knew that we had to bring her here tonight. And so, for an 18-year-old woman, this is her coming out party as a musician. And not only does she have every important music publisher in the world in this room tonight, no pressure, but I got to tell her that she's opening for Steven Tyler. So with that, please welcome Mindy Brash.
Thank you guys so much. I am so honored to be here. And I'd like to thank the NMPA for all the work that they do on behalf of songwriters. It's amazing. And I'd like to give a special thank you to David Israelite for inviting me to come play here. And also, he does such a great job. Let's give him a big round of applause. Come on.
I know that, but I just can't.
comes just once. Tell myself maybe time will help somehow. I'm just sad right now. Thank you so much. So I assume that all of you guys have been to high school. Well, most of you, there's a couple of you in front, maybe not, but. So I graduated from high school a couple years ago. And one of the things that I learned when I was in high school is that if you're different from other people or you don't fit in, then you're really leaving yourself open to ridicule because it's high school. And so I wrote this song for all the girls that I saw who didn't think that they were pretty enough or smart enough or just not good enough in general because there were other girls who were bullying them and making them feel that way. This song is called Better Than. She's a princess, you're a pawn. She's so perfect, you're just wrong. Everything she says and does comes from a world that she'll never be part of. On Olympus with her friends, oh, how you look up to them while they're looking down on you. Down from a place that you'll never get close to. But I promise, promise it gets better than this. Tell me, why should you give half a damn that you're better than? Anything outside the norm, anyone who won't conform, they see as a threat to them. They're gonna fix what's never been broken. Change your makeup, change your hair. Be like them and they might care, but it's always something new. Life is a dress that you'll never fit into. But I promise, promise it gets better than this. Tell me, why should you give half a damn? Because I promise, promise it gets better than this. Tell me, why should you give half a damn? Of the girl I used to be. But I promise, promise it gets better than this. Tell me, why should you give half a damn? Cause I promise, promise that you're better than this. Tell me, why should you give half a damn about someone that you're better than? You're so much better than. Thank you all so much.
Okay. So I think that Bart Herbison is going to start the line of bidders from the music publishers. But thank you so much, Mindy. This is a great event because not only we have a chance to celebrate great music, we're going to have an opportunity to thank the many members of Congress who are so supportive of songwriters and music publishers. We have a lot of members that are here tonight. I think we almost have a quorum, so maybe we ought to call a session and pass our Songwriter Equity Act right here. There's always a danger of forgetting someone, but I want to thank the members of Congress that are here. In particular, I've seen Mr. Conyers, Mr. Goodlatte, Mr. Nadler, Mr. Jolly, Mr. Marino, Mr. Deutsch, Mr. Amade. thank you so much for those members that are here. And we have a senator here who also is a very special person to us. In addition to being the ranking member on the Senate Judiciary Committee, he is someone who is a champion of property rights. And of course, what a songwriter creates is a property right. And if I could ask Elwin Raymer from the Church Music Publishers to join me, I just want to tell you one quick story about Senator Grassley. It's very convenient that we have the Church Music Publishers in town, because Senator Grassley actually has a great story himself about his own church that had a membership of around 200. And when a new music director was brought in and a vibrant music program was brought to the church, they now have grown to a membership of about 2,000 members, just to show you the power of music. And so if Elwin would join me, we are so thrilled to have with us tonight Senator Grassley. We want to present him with an award to thank him for what he does for songwriters, for property rights, and all of that.
Hey, just leave it to a member of Congress to screw up a good party, right? First of all, this award that you see here, I appreciate very much from the National Music Publishers Association, the Church National Publishers Association. Thank you very much. And for the artists that are here, the one that just finished, these people work hard to make sure that you get equity and fairness. And it's a constant battle, but they're constantly on the job. And all of you folks who are members ought to know that they work hard for you. I appreciate very much this award from this standpoint, that artists like this contribute a great deal to the quality of life. And you heard in one church how it enhanced the working relationships of that particular church. More importantly, it seems to me that we talk too much just about quality of life. Artists that these folks work for and protect contribute to the economy of our country very much. So it enhances the quality of life, but it also broadens the economy, and we don't want to forget the benefit of that. And as he talked about intellectual property, as he talked about protecting it, you know darn well that there's people that maybe don't appreciate property rights as much as they should. And when you get into things that are a little more difficult to explain than a new John Deere tractor or something, there might not be the appreciation of it. And the Constitution, specifically one of the powers of Congress, I know all you know this, is to enhance inventions and intellectual property. And it's our job to make sure that people are rewarded for that. And it's respected under the Fifth Amendment like anything else that government can't take or that anybody else can take for that matter. So I want you to know that you work hard for that intellectual property. I am glad to protect our Constitution and everything the Constitution protects. And I thank you very much for your award, and I hope I didn't mess up your program. Thank you.
So we're gonna give the band a few minutes to set up. I'm not worried about anyone leaving, because next is Steven Tyler. He has won multiple Grammys. He has won dozens of Gold and Platinum Awards. He is a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and most importantly, a member of the Songwriters Hall of Fame. Welcome Steven Tyler.
Shaking your ass, Thank you for all showing up. What a wonderful thing. 87 managers ago. How's the room tonight? Light and lively? Remember, rock and roll is a secret, right? I want to thank David Israelite, our illustrious MC, and the NMPA for inviting me here. Also, I want to thank them for sponsoring the Songwriters Equity Act of 2014. Hear, hear. The other reason I'm here, Mr. Smith comes to Washington. Mr. Aerosmith, in this case. And great job, Mindy Brash, who, by the way, if the law continues to be going the way they are, will never be paid fairly for her own participation in the songs she wrote. So really listen up to that one. This is not so much about me tonight as it is about Mindy, this band behind me, Loving Mary, give it up. And my songwriting partner, Marty Fredrickson over here, who wrote this song with me. And so people, forgive me for being a little jaded about the state of copyright and the music biz these days, but enough about that for this second. Check this out. all about the songwriter. And so now here's how it goes. Marty is a songwriter, gets a disproportionate amount of money compared to the recording label and the artist. Okay, did you hear that? You understand that? Pandora pays the record companies 50% of its total revenue as compared to the publishers and songwriters who get 4%. Feedback. Yeah, I believe the three letters WTF goes after that, right? Gotta get rid of that frequency. Come on now, I wasn't here yesterday. See, that's our friend. It's called psychoacoustics. We need to make it equal, don't you think? I mean, really, really. These guys write a song. All right, so you get it. Did you know that in 2013, Tim Westergren, founder of Pandora, cashed out more in stock than Pandora paid every ASCAP songwriter and music publisher combined? Hey, I get it's America. I get freedom, but with freedom comes responsibility. Right? Kind of makes you wonder why the original title of this next song wasn't called I Don't Want to Kiss Your Thing. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. My ring, I meant. Yeah. All right, so thank you, Diane Warren, who gets the 4%, for writing this song that was Aerosmith's only number one hit ever. Even I thought, well, Sweet Emotion, come on. I had to have been. But it was so long ago, it was like, it was those years, so it's all right, I forgot. I know, man, you know, but I know better now, and that's nothing but wrong, nothing but wrong. I love my brother, Marty.
Love you, man.
He and I wrote Jada together. When Sony was going to drop us, they said, you don't have a hit single on there. Well, we did after we wrote that song, but... So check this out. I could stay awake just to hear you breathing. Watch you smile while you are sleeping. While you're far away and dreaming, I could spend my life in this sweet surrender. I could stay lost in this moment forever. Every moment spent with you is a moment I treasure. I don't want to close my eyes. I don't want to fall asleep cause I miss you, baby. And I don't want to miss a thing. Cause even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream will never do, I still miss you, baby. And I don't want to miss a thing. Ooh. Lying close to you, feeling your heart beating. And I'm wondering what you're dreaming. Wondering, is it me you're seeing? Then I kiss your eyes and I thank God we're together. I just wanna stay with you in this moment forever, forever and ever. I don't wanna close my eyes. I don't wanna fall asleep cause I miss you, baby. And I don't wanna miss a thing. Cause even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream will never do, I'd still miss you, baby. Just wanna be with you, right here with you, just like this. I just wanna hold you close and feel you're so close to mine, and just stay here in this moment for all the rest of time. I don't wanna miss a thing, 'cause even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream would never do, I'd still miss you, baby. And I don't wanna miss a thing. I don't wanna close my eyes. I don't wanna fall asleep, 'cause I miss you, baby. And I don't wanna miss a thing, 'cause even when I dream, the sweetest dream would never do, I still miss you, baby. And I don't wanna miss a thing. I don't wanna close my eyes. I don't wanna fall asleep. I don't wanna miss a thing. Wow. Magic! All right. Well, what do you think? Have we passed the audition? Man's representing right here. All right, so check this out. Marty, what? Oh, good. Good. It's all good.
Sweet misery, yeah.
Why, thank you. How about a little bluegrass walk this way? I know you know that song. Let me see, who's the highest ranking official I can get up on stage to? When we're done, at the end of the song, we'll come, okay, we'll do it. Got it. Michelle Obama? No. All right, well, when the moment comes, if you feel so, we'll come up and, oh, okay. At the end of the song. Congressman Converse. Here he is. No. We're gonna save the best for last. Here we go.
Backstroke with that always out of need to cover till I talk to my daddy. Say, I said, you ain't seen nothing, take you down on the mother, then you showed up a change in your way. Met cheerleader was a real young leader, all the times I could reminisce. Oh, the best thing in loving with a sister and a cousin started with a little kiss like this. Seesaw swinging with the balls in the school, with your feet flying up in the air. Sing a happy ditty with your kitty in the middle of swinging like I didn't care. So I took a big chance at the high school dance with a missus who was ready to play. Wasn't me, she was fooling. She knew what she was doing. Told me how to walk this way. Told me to walk this way. Talk this way. Walk this way. Talk this way. She told me to walk this way. Since I got a scratch, climb away up a knee. There was three young ladies in the school gym, and like I wouldn't notice they were looking at me. Was a high school loser, never made it with a lady, tell the boys told me something I missed. But then the next old neighbor with the daughter had a favor, I gave her just a little kiss like this. Who was ready to play? Wasn't me, she was ruling. She knew what she was doing. Told me how to walk this way. Told me to walk this way. Talk this way. Walk this way. Talk this way. What?
Walk this way.
Talk this way.
Walk this way.
Talk this way. Just give me a kiss.
Okay, here we go. Thank you very much. What a beautiful thing. Wow. By the way, everybody, it seems these tech companies know the price of everything but the cost of nothing. So just for the record, you think we're all here because we're not all there? Now maybe. Actually, we're here to protect copyright. There should never be a compulsory license for derivative works, and fair use is even worse. All right, so check this out. Oh, thank you. I do. So if you think it should be any other way, dream on. Every time that I look in the mirror, all the lines on my face getting clearer. The past is gone. When my light dust to dawn, is another way, yeah. Everybody got a doozy life to pay. Well, I know nobody knows where it comes and where it goes. I know it's everybody's sin. You got to lose to know. I don't know. From fools and from sages, you know it's true. All the things come back to you. Sing with it, sing for the ear, sing for laughter, sing for the tear. Sing with it, I'm a jump out today, never tomorrow. I want to thank Loving Mary. And I do so love Mary. Which one of you guys is Mary?
Me.
You. Okay, you're Mary. So, okay, I owe you one or two. Thank you very much.
I want you to know that not only did Stephen come here and play for you for free, but he came up yesterday and walked the halls of that Congress fighting for the rights of songwriters like Mindy. We could not ask for anything more from someone than Stephen Tyler. We have two very special presentations. First of all, we want to thank Marty and the whole band, who were just fantastic. His manager, Rebecca. He's the only rock star I know who has a rock star for an attorney, Dino LaPolt, his attorney. And she's going to join me in presenting Stephen with a very special platinum award. You can barely fit the number of platinum awards on this thing.
There you go, Stephen. Woo!
The other presentation is, tomorrow happens to be a very special day because it's Stephen's birthday tomorrow.
Hey, let's all sing a song.
And so Marty's going to lead us in another song.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Stephen.
On behalf of CMPA and the Board of Directors for the National Music Publishers, thank you so much for coming tonight.